Now we are going to implement a decision tree classifier on iris dataset. Iris dataset is a family of flower which contains three types of flowers, that is setsoa, versicolor and virginica. Now the problem is that we have some features of flower, and based on these features we need to identify which flower belongs to which category. Now we have already implemented this type of problem and we know that it belongs to classification or logistic problem. Now we are going to implement a decision tree which can be used for both classification and regression. We have discussed about the basics of decision tree and now we're going to implement it. So firstly, I've imported, you can see, all the libraries which are required for this execution. And next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to load the data set, that is the iris data. And then I'm going to store this in a data frame. And here I am going to pass the iris data. Dot data. So this is how I have passed it in the data frame. And now I want to print the feature names of iris data which are there. And then I want to print the shape. And then I want to print the first five samples which are there. So like this, you have to write for printing the features name. And here you can write iris data dot feature name. To print the shape, you have to write like this, print iris dot shape. And to print the first five samples, what we used to do is to simply write the head method. So you can write here print iris dot head. So now here you can see that the features name are sepal length, sepal width and the petal width, all in centimeters. And shape is 150 × 4, that means there are 150 rows and 4 columns. So these are the columns and the first 5 records have been displayed to you in the data set. Next, what we are going to do, we are going to print the sample and the target, that what are the sample values and what are the target values. On the basis of features, we will decide that which flower belong to which category by training the model with the data set we have. So like x equals to iris dot values, and here I'm going to give the value 0. And in Y, we are going to get the target. And then we are going to print the X and print the Y also. So here you can see that these are the values which are there, and lastly these are the target value. Now here you can see that 0, 1 and 2 are for setsoa, versicolor and virginia, that means the category, and other are the features of sepal length, sepal width, petal length and petal width. So 0, 1, 2 determines that the category of flower, so that we can categorize the output. Next, we will split the data set into the train set and the test set. and we use the train test split from the sklearn. And here we write x comma y comma test size. Random state. Now, what did this mean? That of course we will not use the whole complete data for training the machine, because then for a full data we will train, then it will give automatically the same output and the, you know, concurrent output, because you have given the all the data to the machine. So we will use some data to train our model, and with the rest of the data we will test. So here basically we have split the data set into two parts. The testing side is 0.3, that means 30% of the data is used for testing and the rest 70% is used for training. Random state, as I've already said in my previous videos, that it can be any integer. The reason behind defining the random state parameters is to initialize a random number generator, which ensures that split that you generate can be reproducible. So as I execute this particular set, that means our data has now been split into training and test. And now what we are going to do is we are going to take the decision tree classifier. So I'm naming it as CLF equals to decision tree classifier random state 100. And next we will fit the training data in this. And the training data is X train and Y train. So we'll write like this, CLF equals to fit, CLF dot fit. And here we will write X train and Y train. So here you can see that a decision tree classifier is there. In this part of the code, decision tree on the iris dataset we have defined has been basically building a model and then fit the training data into that particular classifier. So that has been done. Next, what we need to do, we need to predict for the random data. So like this, you can write in X equals to, now you have to give all the parameters which are there, that is sepal length, sepal width, petal length and petal width. Okay, so you can write like this, let me give the value such as 6.4 comma 1.8 comma 6.6 comma 2.1. These are the values which I am giving. And next what we are doing is we are storing this in y predict equals to CLF dot predict x and then print the y predict. So here it returns me true. That means it is of versicolor. As we have already known that 0, 1, 2 are for Setsoa, versicolor and virginica. Sorry, it is 2. That means it is for virginica. 1 is for versicolor. So now next what we are going to do, we are going to prediction on X test. That means the testing data if you want to predict all the samples. Then you can write like this. Y predict equals to CLF dot predict X test and then we will simply print the Y predict. So here you can see that it generates for all the test data which have been passed and it has predicted it. So that means we have used our trained model for the predictions also. Next, what we are going to do is we are going to check the accuracy of the model and we are also going to print the confusion matrix. So to look at how our model is actually performing. So we'll simply write like this, print accuracy and then we will write matrix dot accuracy score and then we are here going to give the data in which we want to check the score. So we obviously check it for y test and y predict. So firstly, I'm going to write y test, and then I'm going to write the y predict. So this will print us the accuracy of the model. And next, what we're going to print, we're going to print the confusion matrix also. So for that, we write from sklearn dot matrices import confusion matrix. And next, what we do, we store it in a variable and then pass the values of which matrix we want to print, and it is a NumPy array. So we will write like this: NP array confusion matrix of y test and y predict. And lastly, we are going to print the CM. So here you can see that it prints the accuracy score also, and it prints the confusion matrix also. So we can see that we get the accuracy of 95%, which is good. Means our model predict 5% wrong prediction about a category of flower. Confusion matrix is a good way to see the model performance. Here, out of 150 sample, that is 30% is equals to 45 samples are used for testing the purpose. Now in confusion matrix, the 0.00 here you can see that means 16 flowers of the category and 0 are predicted wrong. 1-1, that means 10 flowers of the category and 1 predicted right. Similarly, 2-2, that means 17 here you can see that it actually predicts that 2 predicted right. And these are the correct prediction and these diagonal positions, and rest are the wrong. So basically, according to the confusion matrix, out of 45 samples, 2 samples are predicted wrong and rest are correct. Next, what we are going to do, we are going to plot a decision tree. So for tree plotting, we write like this: tree dot plot tree, and then we pass the model, that is CLF. So here you can see that this is the model which is actually there, and samples and value and median index all are there. So this is actually the decision tree which is made. This is the root node, as I have discussed you. These are the leaf node, this is a leaf node, and this is again a decision node which is further classifying. And this is a leaf node, or can be said as a terminal node, because it ends. So here you can see that the petal length condition has been checked, and according to that a decision tree is made. Now if you want to check decision making in decision tree, that how it is done, then you can write like this: text representation equals to tree dot export text of the CLF and print . So here you can see that this is how the features of each class have been further categorized and the tree has been made. So this is all about the decision tree on the Iris dataset of machine learning. All these particular queries and command have been mentioned in our tutorial also, and the link will be provided to you in the video description for your ease of programming.